Hello, everyone, and welcome inside the WLBM Newsroom. With your WLBM News Weekend Update, I'm Vin Ebenu. A $5,000 reward is now being offered for whoever shot a cat with a crossbow in Howell. Animal control officers rescued the cat after a resident called to report the wounded animal. The cat is recovering, but no arrests have been made yet. A brick woman is charged with bias, intimidation, and harassment after sending threatening and offensive messages to someone on Facebook Messenger. The language of the text included that the, quote, KKK is alive and well in brick, close quote. Denise Scaltrito is also accused of sending messages referencing the Aryan Brotherhood and making derogatory comments regarding the victim's race. Mark your calendars for an awareness campaign taking place later this month by the Ocean County Prosecutor's Office. Love Thy Neighbor, There Is No Room for Hate in Ocean County, runs from May 31st through June 2nd, and is something in which Prosecutor Bradley Billheimer has requested all religious ceremonies or masses address issues related to tolerance and kindness toward others, with recognition that understanding is more important than divisiveness. Lakehurst police place a Toms River woman under arrest after finding ecstasy, codeine, CDS, and drug paraphernalia upon a search of the vehicle she was a front seat passenger in. Alicia Bellamy was heading east in a car on Route 37 when an officer saw that the car was having trouble keeping in the lane of travel. Following a traffic stop where police found the drugs, Bellamy was arrested and brought to the police station for processing. A pickup truck trying to back down a boat launch ramp in brick ends up rolling into the water and becoming submerged when the brake let go. The driver got out to check on the boat and trailer and couldn't get back to the truck in time to reapply the brakes. The boat then floated off of the trailer but was recovered, and the truck was pulled out of the water. Police have tracked down the man they say has been passing fake $100 bills around Lakewood. Erwin Green of Asbury Park is suspected of using the bogus bills on several occasions. The latest was at a kosher grocery store on Madison Avenue. The clerk alerted police, who tracked Green down a short time later. Aside from the counterfeit bills, he had several other outstanding warrants. The tick population in New Jersey could be on the decline if a bill passed by the Assembly Agriculture Committee becomes law. The bill introduced by Jersey Shore Assemblyman Ron Dancer appropriates $250,000 to establish a pilot program to study and develop methods to control ticks. New Jersey is one of the worst states in the nation for Lyme disease, with 37 cases per 1,000 residents and home to at least five species of dangerous ticks. Cases of tick-borne disease have increased by more than 200% in Monmouth County. The Route 37-166 roadwork is now finished after 3 years of construction. Here's a sneak preview of our feature story coming out on Monday with Ryan Blumenthal, the owner of Corinne Jewelers on Route 166, who is discussing the frustration his customers vented to him about on the project.
The first thing out of everybody's mouth was, what a disaster. And it was like, for us, kind of talking about the weather. You know, this construction project was just that common point of pain for every resident in Toms River. Everybody, there was a sense of community that we all hated it, and that, you know, we questioned what the overall purpose of the project was.
Stay tuned to WLBM all weekend long for all the latest Jersey Shore news, weather, and traffic. And make sure you download our free 92.7 WLBM mobile app for all the latest news, weather, traffic, and much more at the tip of your fingers. The download only takes a couple of minutes. I'm Vin Ebenu with your WLBM News Weekend Update.